Hi guys, my friends Harris and Rob are visiting and we decided to go out of town for the night. So we headed over to Bugesera Lodge. The lodge is run by a French Rwandan couple, Jocelyn and her husband Jean-Christophe, who spent many years in Tanzania before relocating to Rwanda. It's only about half an hour south of Kigali, making it the perfect weekend retreat. The roads are a bit rocky, so you'll need a 4x4, or you can take the journey by motor if you're feeling adventurous. The lodge sits in the heart of the Nyabarongo River Basin and is surrounded by natural wetlands, making it a great place to go bird watching. But there's another surprise I want to show Harris and Rob on this trip. The lodge is set in beautiful grounds and the accommodation is wonderfully unique. You stay in round huts that look very traditional from the outside, but modern on the inside. Jocelyn has wonderful taste, and there are small details everywhere, like this Congolese mask on the key fob. At the back of the room, you'll find the shower, and on the other side, the toilet. The gardens are absolutely beautiful, with lots of unusual things to look at. This one is Brugmansia, very beautiful but very deadly. We stopped to take a good look at everything on our way to the restaurant.
That's crazy.
Oh, that's absolutely crazy. Oh, boy.
This one's called a bottle plant because of the shape of its root. The lodge has a beautiful dining area, filled with art and interesting things to look at. There's a foosball and ping pong table, darts, and a bookshelf to keep you occupied. Jocelyn puts on a wonderful French spread with local ingredients. It's a 4-course set menu with starter, main meal, cheese board and dessert, so don't fill up on the first round. You can go for lunch even if you're not staying, but you need to let them know the day before. I'll put the link below. They can also make adjustments for vegetarians and vegans. The next morning, we were up early because I wanted to take my friends on a little adventure. Leaving the lodge, turn left and start walking. Say hello to anyone you meet along the way.
Morning.
After about 10 minutes, you'll find yourself going down a very steep hill. Watch your footing and admire the sun rising over the wetlands. At the bottom of this hill is something I think is absolutely amazing. It's a bridge that stretches about half a kilometre across the wetlands, and it's entirely made out of leaves. You can see where solid ground ends and the bridge begins. It appears to have been built up over years, piling fresh reeds on top of old ones. but I have no idea of the actual history of it. I just find it absolutely fascinating. I've never seen anything like it before. It's solid, but it bounces underfoot. It's like walking across a giant mattress.
I don't want to say. Maybe I'm too amazed by this, but I just think it's incredible.
Yeah, just a feeling.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Wondering if at any moment you're just
going to
go through the bottom.
I would never have known it was here if Jocelyn hadn't told me about it. And I can't help wondering how many other sites like this are hidden around Rwanda that RDB just haven't realised tourists would be interested in. On a practical level, the bridge acts as a shortcut for locals reaching the main road to Kigali, saving them a seriously long walk around the wetlands.
It's like, how did it start is the question. Who first began to do this? And how long did it take? Follow them. So you can really smell the wetlands as well. Better would say.
When you get to the opposite side, you pay 100 francs at the toll booth, which goes towards the upkeep of the bridge. Then you can turn around and come back again. People must think we're a little bit strange. It's quite amazing the amount of traffic the bridge can hold.
Bonjour, mademoiselle.
If you want to cross, it's best to go very early in the morning. The hill to get there is a steep one, and once the sun rises, the wetlands start to become very humid. You also need to go in the dry season, as the bridge can become unstable when the water rises. Avoid walking on the dark patches. Here's the local delivery service arriving.
Whoa. That's incredible. I think somebody's probably gone up top and said, look, there's a couple of Mzungus down there that are dying. Could you go and pick them up?
Watching this lady carrying her baby up the hill is a reminder that for us, this is a fun tourist attraction. But for others, it's everyday life and definitely not as entertaining. Here's somebody harvesting sunflower seeds. By the time we got back to the lodge, it was time for a shower and some food. After breakfast, we decided to go and take a look at one of the lakes in the region. The lodge is about an hour from the Burundian border, and it's a region I've never explored before. Jocelyn suggested we head for a campsite on Lake Cyohoha, which marks the border between the two countries. Unfortunately, GPS decided to take the most direct route rather than the quickest, and we ended up doing some pretty serious off-roading. Instead of taking the nice, shiny new paved highway, we ended up bumping along the back roads.
Thank you.
fun, and we eventually made it to the lake. This is Rwanda on this side, and that's Burundi on the other. We found a large colony of weaver birds building their nests on the shore. We stayed for beer and brochettes and made a couple of friends along the way.
Hello, you're beautiful.
Yeah, that bird's beautiful.
You're beautiful. You've been our dog friend and our cat friend. Did a boomty boom. Had a wee. Had a bit of a wee. Ah! You little one. Mm-hmm. You little one. And a little big one. A little big one. Big one and little one.
It was a really lovely trip, and we managed to find the highway back to Kigali, arriving just before dark. I highly recommend Bugesera Lodge if you want to go for lunch or to get out of town for the weekend, and the floating bridge when the weather allows.